Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the lecture series on the Engineering Thermodynamics. And this is Module 3. We are discussing on second law of thermodynamics. Lecture number 304. We recap from the previous three lectures in the third module. So we discuss about the second law of thermodynamics, the statements, Kelvin-Planck statement and the Clausius statement of second law of thermodynamics. We studied about the Carnot cycle and we derived the efficiency of the Carnot cycle, and we discussed the Carnot theorem and the corollary of Carnot theorem, and we studied about the absolute temperature scale given by the Kelvin. And in this lecture, we are going to discuss about two reversible adiabatic paths cannot intersect each other, and we derive the Clausius theorem, and we'll define the property entropy, we identify the property entropy, and we study about the temperature entropy plot. So the learning outcome for the lecture, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to explain the Clausius theorem and define entropy. So the first topic, two reversible paths cannot intersect. So we consider a thermodynamic cycle A, B, C. There are three processes A, B, B, C and C, A. A, B is reversible isothermal process. B, C is reversible adiabatic process. C, A is also reversible adiabatic process. So the three processes, they constitute a thermodynamic cycle. And we plotted the cycle in PV coordinate. So we know that the area under the PV diagram is the net work done during the cycle. The area under the PV diagram is the net work done under the during the cycle. So we have the space enclosed by area. This is what the net work done during the cycle. And in this cycle, the line BC and CA, they are intersecting at C. So the reversible adiabatic line, they are intersecting. Now we look at the condition. AB is the isothermal process and BC reversible adiabatic process, CA reversible adiabatic process. So in the process BC and CA, there is no possibility of heat transfer. So for reversible adiabatic process, there is no heat transfer. So for BC and CA, there is no heat transfer, and there is only possibility, there is heat transfer only in the process AB. So AB is the heat transfer process, BC there is no heat transfer, CA there is also no heat transfer. So the cycle is violating Kelvin-Planck statement. What is the Kelvin-Planck statement? It is impossible to construct a cyclic heat engine to produce net work output by exchanging heat with a single fixed temperature, reservoir of single fixed temperature. Now, this is the thermodynamic cycle. Exchanging heat with a single process, AB process, right, and then producing net work output. So, this is not possible. So, the intersecting, the two reversible adiabatic path cannot intersect each other. So this conclusion is required for further discussion. So here the reversible adiabatic process BC and AC intersect at C. The area included in the PV diagram is net work done during the cycle, but such a cycle is impossible as there is net work output in the cycle by exchanging heat only with one reservoir, which violates the Kelvin-Planck statement of second law of thermodynamics. So, intersecting of two adiabatic lines is not possible. So, this is you have to remember. So, two adiabatic lines, in any PV diagram, when you draw in future, two reversible adiabatic lines should not intersect. That is what the conclusion or inference we derive from this discussion. And we discuss the Clausius theorem. So, for the derivation of the Clausius theorem, we consider a reversible process IF. So, IF is the process, curved line. IF is the process. Now, through I draw one reversible adiabatic line, and through F, I draw another reversible adiabatic line. So, this is again PV diagram. So, IF is the process. We draw one line, reversible adiabatic line through I. Through F, again we draw another line, reversible adiabatic line. And the area under the curve is the work done. The area under the curve is the work done. Now, we draw a line AB. So, this point is A. AB, we draw a line AB such that the area under the line AB is equal to IF. Now, using the first law of thermodynamics, Q equal to delta U, UF minus UI plus W. So, QIF, heat transfer equal to change in internal energy plus work done. So, QIF equal to UF minus UI plus WIF. So, heat transfer during this cycle, during this process equal to change in internal energy plus work done during the process. Now, we take a process. So, you take the line IABF. IABF. Now, for the process IABF, 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 this line, again we apply the first law of thermodynamics, process QIABF equal to UF minus UI plus WIABF. So, since WIF equal to WIABF, so this QIF equal to QIABF. So, the process for the, actually we compare these two equations. So, UF, UI, 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 WIF, WIABF. So, how we draw the line, straight line? It is, condition is, the work done during the curved line IF is equal to the work done during the IABF. That is what the condition. So, comparing these two equations, QIF equal to QIABF. That is what our conclusion. Now, QIABF equal to QIA plus QAB plus QBF. We split into two. QIA plus QAB plus QBF. QIA equal to 0 because it is reversible adiabatic process. QBF is also equal to 0. It is again reversible adiabatic process. So, QIF, left hand side QIF equal to QAB. So, the heat transfer in the curved line is equal to heat transfer in the straight line. That is what the conclusion. Heat transfer in the curved line is equal to heat transfer in the straight line. Now, using this conclusion, we are going to derive the Clausius theorem. So, initially, we have IF is the curved path, we make it as a straight line, we draw the three lines, reversible adiabatic line through I, through F, and connecting the two reversible adiabatic line, we draw one inclined line, we draw the reversible isothermal line. Now, using the first law of thermodynamics, we conclude that QIF equal to QAB. So, using this conclusion, we are going to derive the Clausius theorem. Now, you consider a curve, the smooth curve, as a cycle, thermodynamic cycle. So, this is plotted in the PV coordinate. We take a cycle, smooth curve, that is what the thermodynamic cycle. So, consider a smooth closed curve representing a reversible cycle, and we split the smooth curve into number of elemental cycles. How to convert into number of elemental cycles? We draw number of parallel reversible adiabatic lines. So, like this, reversible adiabatic, these are all reversible adiabatic lines. So, this is the first reversible adiabatic line, this is the second reversible adiabatic line. So, in this reversible adiabatic line, so we have a curve, we have two curves. So, here we draw an isothermal line, here we draw an isothermal line. And this AB, C, D, it becomes the Carnot cycle, reversible Carnot cycle. So, the Carnot cycle consists of reversible isothermal expansion, reversible adiabatic expansion, reversible isothermal compression, and reversible adiabatic compression. So, four processes, and this ABCD constitute a reversible Carnot cycle. So, for elemental cycle ABCD, we have for Carnot cycle we derived earlier del Q1 by T1 equal to del Q2 by T2. So, del Q1 is the amount of heat supplied at temperature T1, del Q2 is the amount of heat rejected in the cycle at T2. So, heat supplied by corresponding temperature equal to heat rejected by the corresponding temperature. Now, heat supplied is positive and heat rejected is negative. So, the left right hand side is negative minus of del Q by T, del Q2 by T2. So, we take the del Q2 by T2 to the left side and this become del Q by Q1 by T1 plus del Q2 by T2 equal to 0. So, for the first cycle, for the elemental cycle ABCD, what is our conclusion? Del Q by Q1 by T1 plus del Q2 by T2 equal to 0. Now, similarly for the next cycle, we take the next cycle. Next cycle is EFGH, EFGH. For the next cycle EFGH, del Q3 by T3 plus del Q4 by T4 equal to 0. Now, similarly, we have many more cycles. So, we calculate all the values, add all the values, del Q1 by T1 plus del Q2 by T2 plus del Q3 by T3 plus del Q4 by T4 plus goes to number of cycles, this equal to 0. So, del Q1 by, so the entire cycle is now converted into number of Carnot cycle. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 heat supply process, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 heat rejection process. So, the heat addition divided by the temperature, heat addition divided by the temperature, heat addition divided by the temperature, heat addition is like that, we can add all the values. So, sum of all the values equal to 0. Now, we make it as a single statement, cyclic integral of del Q by T equal to 0 for reversible path. So, R stands for the reversible path. So, in a reversible cycle, cyclic integral of del Q by T equal to 0, and this is known as Clausius theorem. So, del Q by T equal to 0, that is what the Clausius theorem, cyclic integral of, so the symbol, right, integral with a circle in between, that is called a cyclic integral of del Q by T equal to 0, and for reversible cycle. So, the R stands for the reversible cycle. What is Clausius theorem? For a reversible cycle, the cyclic integral of del Q by T equal to 0, and this is valid for the reversible cycle. And we identify the property entropy. So, from the Clausius theorem, we identify the property entropy. So, we take a PV diagram once again. We take a process I to F. So, there are two paths R1 and R2. So, from the state I, through the path R1, the system is taken to the final state F. Then it is brought back to the second initial state through the cycle, through the path R2. R1, R2, they are reversible path. So, from Clausius theorem, del Q by T for R1, R2 equal to 0. So, del Q by T for R1 plus del Q by T for R2 equal to 0. For the R1, R2 equal to 0. So, del Q by T for the first R1, path R1 equal to from I to F. So, I to F integral of del Q by T for R1 path plus integral of F to I R2 path del Q by T equal to 0. So, I take to the second term to the right side. So, I to F integral I to F del Q by T equal to minus integral F to I del Q by T. Now, what we do? On the right hand side, we drop the negative sign by changing the direction. So, left hand side as it is, I to F del Q by T, minus N, we are dropping the minus sign. So, the F to I is changed to I to F del Q by T. Now, what do you see from here in this line? I to F del Q by T equal to I to F del Q by T. Mathematically, it is correct. But the condition is, this is for path R1 and this is for path R2. So, whatever the path followed, what is the conclusion from this statement here? whatever the path followed, del q by t is the same. So, since r1 and r2 represent the two reversible path, so whatever the path followed, del q by t is independent of the path. Independent of the path. When it is independent of the path, so there is a property. So, we studied the path function, point function in the first unit. So, when it is a path function, it is not the property. When the parameter, thermodynamic parameter is a path function, it is not a property. So, the entropy is independent of the path. It is not depending on the path. So, it is a property now. So, we identify a property. So, del q by t is independent of the path, r1 and r2. So, there exists a property called entropy. The unit is joules per Kelvin. So, q is in joules and t is in Kelvin, joules per Kelvin. And integral of I to F del q by t equal to Sf minus Si or del q by t equal to dS. Del q by t equal to dS. So, the change in entropy equal to del q by t. And this equation is very important for all our thermal engineering discussion. dS equal to del q by t. So, where dS is the exact differential and property is a point function. Entropy is a point function property of the system. So, del q by t is independent of the path. So, it is depending on the point. It is depending on the end point. So, when your parameter is depending on the end point, it is a property of the system. So, entropy is the property of the system. And the entropy per unit mass. Entropy per unit mass is called a specific entropy mentioned by small s with the unit of joules per kilogram Kelvin. So, specific entropy or entropy is very important parameter for all our thermal engineering calculation. And the Clausius in the year 1865 had discovered the property entropy. So, from the Clausius theorem, he derived the entropy, identified the property called entropy. The entropy of a system is a measure of the degree of molecular disorder existing in the system. So, entropy, so looking at a microscopic level, entropy is a measure of molecular disorder in the system. So, entropy is a measure of molecular disorder in the system. So, when the heat is imparted to the system, the disorderly motion of the molecule increases and the entropy of the system increases. When the heat is added, so the disorderly motion will increase and the entropy of the system will increase. Similarly, when the heat is removed, entropy of the system will decrease. So, entropy depends on the heat transfer. When more heat is given, there will be more change in entropy. When the heat is removed, there will be decrease in the entropy. So, we engineers, we are concerned with the change of entropy, not on the absolute entropy. So, we calculate S2 minus S1. We do not bother about the absolute entropy S. So, we always calculate delta S, change in entropy. For isentropic process, there is no change in the entropy. So, the isentropic process, reversible adiabatic process is the isentropic process. So, reversible adiabatic process is the isentropic process and there is no change in the entropy. There is no entropy transfer associated with energy transfer as work. So, when there is work transfer, there is no change in the entropy. So, entropy change occur only due to the heat transfer. That you have to remember. So, temperature entropy plot are the of the Carnot cycle. So, we have four processes in the Carnot cycle. Reversible adiabatic expansion 1 to 2. 2 to 3 reversible isothermal compression. So, 3 to 4 reversible adiabatic compression and 4 to 1 reversible isothermal expansion. So, look at the diagram. T1. The top of the cycle T4 equal to T1. That is T1 temperature T1. The higher temperature is T1, lower temperature is T2. The amount of heat supplied is Q1, capital Q1, amount of heat rejected is capital Q2. This is the expansion work and the compression work. So, the x-axis is the entropy and the y-axis is the temperature of the plot. Right? Now, what we find? S1 equal to S2 and S3 equal to S4. So, this is what we observe from the diagram. S1 equal to S2, S4 equal to S3. T1 equal to T4 equal to T1, T2 equal to T3 equal to T2. So, this is the normally we refer this higher temperature, is the lower temperature. For reversible process, we said del Q by T equal to dS. So, del Q equal to T dS or integrating Q equal to T into S2 minus S1. That is what the Q equal to T into S2 minus S1, and we define the Carnot cycle efficiency, which is Q1 minus Q2 divided by Q1. So, Q1 heat separate, this equal to T1 into S1 minus S4 minus Q2 equal to T2 into S2 minus S3 divided by T1 into S1 minus S4. And using this, S3 equal to S4, S2 equal to S1. So, we will get T1 minus T2 divided by T1 is equal to 1 minus T2 by T1. So, the efficiency of the Carnot cycle equal to 1 minus T2 by T1. Net work transfer equal to Q1 minus Q2, which is equal to T1 minus Q2 into S1 minus S4. So, the temperature entropy plot. Now, we look at here, Carnot cycle efficiency equal to 1 minus Q2 by T1. 1 minus Q2 by T1. That is the conclusion. So, we stop here. So, these are all the reference book I used for preparing the slides. So, you can also refer to it for additional information. And you can write to me to my mail ID for any queries on the subject. So, thank you for watching. We'll meet again.